I'm Chris.
And I'm Gav.
And today we're at Newcastle Film and Comic Con.
No, we're not.
Wait, not yet. This is after we've been, but you'll see it in the next clip. This is the Retro Saga. Are you dressed as a Joker?
Yeah, I always get dressed up. I get dressed up every time we go. It's a family thing for me. All the family get dressed up. We generally go as Batman and all these entourage as well, like, so. Yeah, I'm dressed up. Let's get back to the episode.
Well, we're at Newcastle Film and Comic Con. Out the entrance, about to go in. Try to go and see what's inside.
Yeah!
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Yeah? It's like the
choice moving out, so this.
He's
a priority, he's getting
laid
up.
Yeah, we're coming! Yeah! We're so used to
him, we're approximately 5 minutes.
He's a beast. He's a beast. He's a beast.
Right, I would normally do first impressions, but we've been a few times before this one, haven't we?
Yeah, we've been there before.
I've been 3 times, you've maybe been 2?
That's the second time there, yeah, so...
So, like, what did
you... kind of knew what we're expecting. It was quieter than last time. Mm-hmm. It was all set out pretty much the same as last time, though, which is wasn't a bad thing, because it was set out pretty well before.
Yeah. It is a good setup because you walk in and you have all the stalls in the middle of the arena and you have boards right around where the seats are. So if you're inclined to, you can go and sit in the seats and listen to talks with the, I wouldn't say celebrities, the special guests as they call them who arrive. And you also have like cosplay events going on down the outside. And down the bottom half of the arena, they have all the celebrities there. Our concept again, special guests. I suppose you have celebrities.
Yeah, the people know them, yeah. They book them as...
If you want to go and see them, if you're interested in the Star Wars or whatever, the celebrities to you, so...
If Big Brother can call itself Celebrity Big Brother and stuff like that, I'm pretty sure they can call them celebrities. Yes.
A man in an Ewok suit is a celebrity to me.
Yeah.
I would if I had it.
Standard. Have you
caught him?
Good luck. Want a new table, Gav? Anything you're thinking about, Gav?
Just trying to see what the Game Boy games are. That'll go back there.
This store really to see what they had. Wasn't a great lot.
No, there wasn't a massive selection.
No, I think the best selection was probably the G- Game Boy games at the back. you were struggling to read what he said, really.
Yeah, they were that far at the back.
Yeah.
They're all little baggies and all, weren't they?
Little,
so struggling.
Yeah, little almost see-through bags where you could like vaguely make out a couple of game names, and they were pretty expensive, high-end price probably. I wouldn't say expensive, just...
Yeah, there was one or two decent games, but it was one of those stores that didn't specialise in games or anything in particular, so you were never going to get anything special.
No.
Or nothing, and they were a bit high-priced. But it was alright. I mean, for the... It was the first store we found games on, so we were just happy to see them, really.
Yeah.
Whoa, that looks so cool.
What?
That.
Dinosaur.
All of that. Lego.
Lego. All the Lego things.
Yeah. Can you even get it?
Yes.
Can you even get them?
Yeah. No Marvel figures, got you interested?
I like them. But I haven't got any, and I wouldn't be bothered about going looking for them unless they were really cheap or something. And then I'd probably just buy them and see if you wanted them.
Yeah.
But I mean, I've got the Batman chess collection, which is pretty much exactly the same.
Yeah. Like, you can get two sets, can't you? You can get just the Batman chess collection, can't you? Or you also get the Justice League chess collection, which is like everyone in the DC universe?
Yeah. There's quite a few of the others in the Batman one. I'm not sure if they're originally Batman bad guys or what, but yeah, they, some of them do cross over, I think. But I do have some of the Justice League one as well. What I didn't realise, that they stopped going from Batman and started doing the Justice League, so I have a few.
Yeah.
But not the full set.
Well, I mean, I have a couple of Marvel figures myself already. Just two. I just have Thanos and Captain America. And I wouldn't mind collecting more, but not the full set, just the Avengers, really. Because there is loads, if you look out there, they come as a monthly subscription in a magazine. And they just get expensive if you want them all. I mean, they do some fantastic figures, like Iron Fist and Daredevils, but I'm not interested in them. Just the ones that interest me, really, so I'll just try and pick them up loose where I can. But not for them prices. They were £15, £20, £25, weren't they?
They were expensive, yeah. I'm pretty sure they're about the tenner or inch, are they, when you get them on the monthly or the bi-weekly subscription?
I can't remember. I know the first one's always about £2, and then the second one's about a tenner. Then after that, they should jump up to crazy prices, don't they?
Can't remember.
But I'll just keep on the lookout. Gumtree, people will get tired of the subscriptions and cancel and they want to get rid of them. That's where I'll step in.
It's like a vulture.
If you're worthy, we are all doomed.
Of course I'm worthy. The Joker would be awesome with that hammer.
It would be. Now that's a comic I would read. The Joker with Milnoir, or however you pronounce it.
Then I'm gonna like it back.
I've just sold Captain America. I've just been over once.
What are you thinking about getting, Chris?
Oi, I'm not looking right now, but I am looking for No Man's Land Volume 4. And I keep looking everywhere, no one seems to have it yet.
Just Volume 4?
Why, I've already got Volumes 2 and 3, and I've borrowed Volume 1 off you and read that. So that's as far as I'm up to at the moment, so I need Volume 4. So I'll see if I can find it. Want some games, Gav?
Want some games?
Mm-hmm.
goals and goes.
Good game.
Good game.
A bit rich for my blood though.
How much?
Only £4.
Oh.
Not get that much knocked off.
Any price?
Hey, hey.
No.
Do you think Kirby Avalanche is anything like Dr. Mario?
Dr. Mario?
It is Dr. Mario.
We got there, Gav?
Capcom Generations.
R10.
You get there?
I might put it back and have a look back later, we'll see.
Yeah, I think we're best off having a look around and coming back.
I like the collection of these games. We'll have a look. We'll have a look around first.
So, we found another game stall. This was a fully all-only game stall. No, yeah. Like, keychains or pillows or swords, yeah, or anything like that.
Dedicated to games.
Yeah, dedicated game stall with a really good selection, really. Like,
yeah.
Nothing too old, nothing new, really, I don't think, was it?
No, not many. I mean, it was basically PS2 was mainly the newest,
pretty much
all they had on offer, so it was good for retro.
It was good, like, yeah. They had plenty of PS1 and PS2 games,
yeah,
which I like. A few Super NES, a few Mega Drive, no special titles in them, really, like, there was one or two that were good titles, but they were priced to be good titles. I mean, same with a lot of it though, you know, if something's selling for 150 on eBay, people will try to get 150 at the conventions, or maybe it's even a bit more, depending on how good they think the copy is.
I mean, that was his only trouble. I mean, you did all the looking, because as you said there, it was just a bit too expensive. Good selection, but very expensive. So we thought we'd check out the rest of the convention first and maybe come back later. Because there was just nothing there that, like, grabbed you at first. I mean, they had a handful of games for each platform. There wasn't, like, a massive selection for Nintendo or a massive selection for Super Nintendo. Just had a selection for each platform. So we just thought we'd come back later, really.
Yeah. Problem could have been that because we did turn up so late, that the good stuff might have just
gone. You might have sold all the good stuff, yeah.
Probably was. I mean, there was a full day before we turned up, you know, a full day and a half even, really, wasn't it? I mean, there was a full Saturday, which would have been a lot busier.
Yeah.
And then there was the morning, which would have had quite a few there as well, so.
That's the key to it. I could do the other bot check, right? It's got the bot 111 on the back, and then repair.
For baby Charlie.
I'm expecting a daughter in about 8 weeks now, and I feel sorry for her already. I mean, the stuff I've bought is, I've already got her a Zelda bibs, and Zelda baby grows, and yeah, Batman costumes. You know what I mean? So I think my daughter's going to be thrust upon nerd. So I don't know. She's Charlotte on a Sunday, but Charlie for the rest of the time. And like, what can I say? I think I feel sorry for her.
It's not all you though, is it, Chris?
No, even my wife is just as bad. I mean, this is what she's got already. A Snow White costume. So, and speaking of my wife, this next clip I had to put in just for her, because it's the only thing she got excited about all day. So, check this clip out. Typical woman. Only gets excited about shows.
Well, I've got a special announcement to make. I know I said Charlie was due in 7 or 8 weeks' time, the daughter. And I felt sorry for her, being a fussed upon nerd. She must have wanted to be a nerd because she's here early, 7 weeks early in fact. Charlotte was born at the weekend.
She's doing fine, nice and healthy, just needs to go strong for it and bring her home. But yeah, I'm a dad already.
Chris, did you go see any celebrities while you were there?
No, not this year. I mean, the only celebrity there who would have interested was Happy Hatebridge, Holly Hart, Red Dwarf. But she wasn't at the booth, was she? It was but she wasn't sat at the table. But apart from that, there was no one else there that really tickled us this year. I mean, there has been some good ones in the past. I mean, last year there was the woman out of Terminator. She was there.
Yeah, Terminator 3.
Darth Maul was there.
Yeah. Who else was there? Hardcore Holly was there.
Yeah, Hardcore Holly.
The wrestler.
Yeah.
Spike out of Buffy the Vampire Slayer was there.
Well, my wife met him, actually got the photo taken and got the autograph and all that. She enjoyed that. She's a massive Buffy fan.
There was quite a few for Doctor Who and stuff like that, wasn't there?
Yeah, well, I think it was a Doctor Who push last year, because there was lots from there.
Yeah.
And again, they all seem to have like a fame going on, either Star Wars fame or, I mean, they actually have a good selection. I'm normally quite impressed. There was only this year, there wasn't the greatest selection. Like I said, there was only Holly from Red Dwarf, who I would have seen, but obviously she wasn't there at the time.
She was there, but we just didn't see her when
we didn't see her when we were there, yeah.
Yeah, it's not like she snubbed them.
No. Not like Craig Charles. Yeah, he was supposed to be there last year, and he stepped out. I'll start from the beginning. A couple of years ago, he was supposed to be at Durham Comic Con, so I got excited to see him, booked me tickets. I think the day before, he pulled out at the last minute.
Yeah.
Stepped out, snubbed us all. But luckily, Norman Lovett, who plays Holly in Red Dwarf, he actually stepped in last minute. And he was a great guy. I mean, we met him and it was great conversation. He signed me a book for us and just good conversationist. He didn't hold nothing back.
Yeah, he'd have stopped and talked, yeah. He wasn't as much.
Yeah, it wasn't like
sign
head down
this and then you're like,
next. We actually stood and had some good conversation.
Yeah.
So,
it's all you want if you stand in the queue for what was it, a half an hour queue?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah,
an hour queue maybe. You want more than 10 seconds of seeing someone write a name in your book.
Yeah.
You want to have like, oh, what was it like then? Just a little background information is all you need, really, isn't it?
Well, you spoke only about Red Dwarf, now, because I joked about the new series coming up, is he in it? And he said he hadn't received no script yet, and just joking on about stuff like that. But obviously, so I wasn't too worried about Craig Charles that time, so I met another one of me Red Dwarf people, Norman Lovett. Then the next time, it was supposed to be at Newcastle Comic Con last year, and last minute he stepped out again. Just no replacement, no excuse, he wasn't coming.
Yeah. It wasn't as much last minute as the Newcastle one, the Durham.
No, I think it was a few weeks before this one.
Yeah, they had a bit of time, but they have that many. I mean, Durham only has one celebrity at a time, don't they?
Yeah.
Newcastle have a few at the same time, so they didn't bother replacing them.
Yeah.
So.
But then, third time, I thought I'd go to his gaff down London, because I got tickets to see them film the new series of Red Dwarf. So I thought, oh, brilliant. Not only will I meet Craig Charles, I meet the whole cast. And to be fair, when we got there, I mean, Crichton was fantastic, crowd interaction. The Cat, he was brilliant, crowd interaction. Chris Barry, he was a bit under the weather that day, and you could see he flogged through, he was a trooper to actually get the show filmed, and he tried his best. But Craig Charles, nothing. He just a couple of funny faces to the camera in between takes, but nothing to the crowd. And I thought, you know, third time now, I'm taking it personally. It's like you're snubbing me.
Yeah.
Me and you, Craig Charles, we are not boys from the Dwarf. We done.
You've upset this poor lad here.
Oh, he's on my nemesis list. He is, he's up the top. Right above you. Well, that's it for part one of our Newcastle film of Comic Con.
Johnson. See you in part two.
Yeah, see you in part two. Yes, that's my Zelda cup. How loud did you gulp?
Aye.
Pig.
How
do you pronounce it on his name? When you want?
Milnia.
Milnia.
Milnia or something like
that. Milnia.
Milnia. Milnia.
Milnia.
Milnia.
Milnia. A joker with Milnia, or however you pronounce it.
Sounds like film noir.
The destruction in chaos would be awesome.